For a majority of us, there are certain areas of fat that we would rather not have. Dr. Sessa joins us in the studio today to discuss how to put some of that fat to good use with fat grafting. Hello, doctor. Welcome back.
Thanks. Great to be back.
So fat grafting,
yeah.
Let's talk about that. And how do you treat something like that? What do you do with it?
So very interesting. You know, fat has sort of been all the rage for the last probably 8 to 10 years in cosmetic surgery. It's a great volumizer. So if you think about it, if you look at the face, anywhere between the eyes down to the mouth, the middle part of your face, if you will, sort of loses volume as you get older. As you age, you lose volume around your eyes. The volume that you used to have in your cheeks sort of falls downwards and inwards and leaves these sort of depressions in and around the sides of your face.
Right.
So what we do is very simply take some fat from your tummy, from your thigh, area.
Can your patients decide on where they want to take it from?
Yeah, of course, yeah. The bad news is that I don't take a lot of it.
Oh, okay.
It's a very small amount.
All right.
So a lot of my patients, you know, jokingly say, please take it all. take as much as you want. But unfortunately, I only need, you know, maybe a small amount, maybe a half a cup full.
Oh, darn.
So, but that goes a long way. So I take that fat. I don't treat it in any way. I just remove it under a procedure that's essentially painless and scarless. I compact it. So I put it in something that spins it down and compacts it. And then I inject the compacted fluid into the areas. Now, fat is very different than other volumizing things like, you know, other products that you may have gotten that use hyaluronic acid or other things that are sort of come out of a syringe to help fill in creases or wrinkles.
Right.
This is a little bit different in that all these other products are generally placed at a very superficial layer.
Right.
Fat is placed at a very deep layer. It's placed almost on the level of the muscle and the bone. So if you think about it, we're lifting the house. We're not just spackling a crack, if you will.
Okay.
So so I could put in lots of fat and fill out your face. Now, the thing about fat is that a couple of things. One is that it's highly rejuvenative. It has a high amount of stem cells in fat. It's been shown that there's more stem cells in fat than in your bone marrow.
Wow.
So that is the rejuvenating aspect of using fat in and of itself. The second thing that's very nice is that it's your own substance.
Exactly.
Yeah. So you don't have to worry about any allergic reaction. Yeah. It's not going to have some sort of untoward side effect because it's your own fat.
Right. No chemicals.
It's just yours. It's just you. That's right. So the one caveat to fat grafting is that you will lose about 40% of it over the course of 3 to 6 months. But the good news is that of that 40% you lose, the rest of it you keep, and it's essentially permanent.
Okay, can you do it again? Can you, when you lose that percentage, can you come back and have it done again, and then how long will that last?
Absolutely. So it's always going to have about the same longevity. The good news is I take the fat from problematic areas. Outer thighs, hips, lower stomach. As we get older, those areas are very difficult to lose. So the fat is very resistant to breakdown. Now, if we did the fat grafting and then all of a sudden you went on a crash diet and lost 30 pounds, more than likely you're going to lose that fat. But if you had that procedure done and you basically stay at the same weight that you're at, it will remain there, essentially permanent, barring any drastic changes in your lifestyle.
Okay. And what are some of the other things that you can expect to happen if you don't make any drastic changes in your life? I mean, what are the benefits, obviously, is that your skin looks healthier?
Yeah. So the main benefit of fat grafting is the volumetric enhancement. It works really, really well when combined with other procedures. Mm-hmm. So most everyone, as we get older, it's not that, yeah, your skin is sagging, right? But it's that you've lost water in your skin, you've lost collagen in your skin, mm-hmm. you've lost fat in and around your skin and structures. So now gravity takes over and now things are sagging. Mm-hmm. So if we do, let's say we do a facelift, let's say we do laser. Mm-hmm. So now we not only tightened up the muscle structure, now we also tightened up the skin and rejuvenated the skin, mm-hmm. but now there's that sort of intermediary level. So if we add the volume, and we add volume and enhance the cheeks, cover up around under the eyes, right. maybe fill in the creases around your nose, mm-hmm. it looks exponentially better. And the fat will stick around longer because the general structure of your face has been changed.
Has been improved.
So I'm not trying to rebuild what I just did by giving you surgery,
right.
by just giving you fat.
Mm-hmm.
So volumetrically, you can enhance and rejuvenate someone's face, but it's less likely to last as long mm-hmm. as if you had it combined with a surgical procedure.
Okay.
But it all works well, and I find a lot of people say, you know, it's not something, I'm not ready for surgery yet. I want to do something non-surgical. Yeah. I consider fat grafting essentially non-surgical because mm-hmm. there's no scars.
Right.
So, and it's an outpatient procedure that's performed under local anesthesia. And it works really well, and it gives people back that volume. And just that fullness and that volume is enough to make you look
and
5 to 10 years
and
younger.
Feel better.
Yeah.
And these are all the types of things that when a client comes in for a consultation with you, like again, you said you'll give them, you know, your suggestions and work with them on what they're comfortable with.
Right.
Right. Okay.
Of course.
Well, again, always a pleasure seeing you, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks.
All right.
Look forward to it.
Stay tuned. Aging Gracefully. We'll be right back.